But Lord, you found me. I was blind, 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 but now I can see. It's amazing how you love me. Amazing. It's amazing how you love me. How you die on it's the cross. It's amazing how for me. You love me. It wasn't easy. It's amazing how but you still did. You love me. It's amazing it's how. Amazing. You love me. It's amazing how you love me. You love me. When I look back over my life and I see where you've taken me, it's amazing how it's so amazing. You love me. Hey, you love me so patient. Lido, I'm not at my best. I'm not at my best. You love me so. Lord, you're very patient. Lido, even though I'm not at my best. I'm not at my best. In spite of my faults. You love me so. So patiently.
How you love me so, God. How you love me so. How you love me so. It's amazing how you love me so, Papa.
How you love me so. You love me. I was blind, 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 but now I can see. It's amazing how you love me. Amazing. It's amazing how you love me. How you die on it's the cross. It's amazing how for me you love me. It wasn't it's amazing how but you still did. You love me. It's amazing. It's amazing how. You love me.
Yes, a blessed good evening, and it's great to be here again tonight on another broadcast of the Bread of Life. It's great being here with you, being in your homes, being with you wherever you are watching us from. We want to say we thank God for you granting us the honor of being a part of this program. We pray you've been blessed. We pray you are learning. And we pray that we are growing together. My heart desire is that we learned and that we developed to be able to make the kind of an impact that God wants us to make personally in our lives, our families, community, nation, and the world at large. I believe that we are those agents of change that the world is looking forward to. And we're not going to disappoint our generation. As you know, we've been following on the power and the benefit of great decisions. So we've been following over the past evenings on the Bread of Life broadcast of the So Winning Evangelistic Ministries. And it's happening on Swami TV. And through the day, we have the program running on our how you call it, watch party. So you can go on our page and be able to follow us on watch party. Most of the messages are there. They can build your spirit and develop you. You love me patiently, though. I'm not... at my best, but you still love me. You love me so.
How you love me so.
Yes, Lord, how you love me so. It's amazing.
It's amazing.
Yeah.
Amazing. How you love me so. How you love me so. How you love me so. It's amazing. How you love me so, Papa.
How you love me so.
You love me.
Yes, Lord, you love me tonight. You sacrifice yourself for me. It's amazing. Amazing. Our own Princess Nora. Opening us. It's always the way the broadcast starts. Every evening. It's amazing. It's amazing. Amazing.
How you love me so.
You love me.
How you love me so.
You love me.
How you love me so, it's amazing. In all the book of Ephesians, tell us Ephesians 1, behold, our man, our love the Father, had lavished upon us that we be called his children. What an honor, what a release. He loves you so much, Jeff. He called you his son, his daughter. It's amazing. When you look at the situations, the things we're going through, the experiences we have, the kind of a thing our lives have gone through, and what the Lord has continued to do to sustain and keep us. It's amazing. It's amazing. How you love me so. Somebody have been worshiping tonight.
How you love me so. How you love me so.
It's amazing. Yeah. Thank you tonight, Lord. We are awesomely grateful to you for loving us. Oh, we want to thank God tonight. It's so good to be here in His presence. We thank God for all of you, all of you, all of you wonderful people who can even take up your time to be a part of our broadcast and make sure that our life is a blessing to you, that you can appreciate our ministry. We'd like to hear from you. You know, it's important. We follow you, a lot of you watch, a lot of you are online, but we don't get a lot of response from some of you. And we also discussed some of you are not consistent. We want to encourage you that this is a time of discovery and learning. And the more you spend time, keep up the data so you'll be able to follow up and progress. And the messages that I've been taught are to strengthen all of us and make us, you know, perform and deliver that the Lord wants us to do, you know, to His glory and honor. I want to encourage you tonight. Make sure you do that to the glory of God. Well, bless God, our own daughter, Princess Snow Yensea. Oh yeah, taking us. We go on the way with her tonight. Yeah. Now we're going to growing up. It's talking about maturity. Decisions. It's a testimony, you know. It's a testimony she made. She made decisions today. Her life is paid because there was part of the decision. No, they were a little bit hard. Yeah. Growing up. Yeah.
Too late.
I leave it at an orphan. But I thank God for my growing up. That no matter what happened, I didn't give up. I was committed. I remained dedicated. I submitted to some things I should have submitted to. Yeah, I went to school. They took a decision to go to school.
With no breaks.
No breaks in between. Growing up.
Growing up.
Oh, thank you, princess. It also, what an inspiration from God. God has blessed this nation with some powerful. I have to sell if I'm glad. Sell. I thank God for my growing up. I was not angry. I didn't die. No.
I
didn't come out. Yeah, true ups and downs. Things will be rosy. Things will be always the way I wanted to be. But I thank God that
He kept me.
Kept me safe. It was by His grace. Yeah. I'm in this place where you find me right now. Where I'm having a dream to get that God. My story is enough to give God praise. I can't do them bad times to give God praise. I praise you It's time to go to prayer, yes. For my growing up. Yeah. I praise you for my growth. Yeah.
I didn't drown.
Yeah. Yeah.
So I
thank God. Yeah.
He kept me safe.
Listen to me. You are a pillar of God's protection, God's shield, God's defense, God's faithfulness.
So thank God.
Yeah.
My story is enough to keep God praise. I've had good and bad times to give God praise.
I praise Him. Thank you, Princess.
I praise him. My growing up.
Oh, my cabaret will shut up about it. Na 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 na.
La la la.
Yeah. My testimony. Oh, it's time to pray.
Yeah.
It's time to pray. Lord, we present ourselves tonight.
So don't make me happy. You never know what that word.
Yeah.
Oh, this God is locked, but I say bless.
Yes, that's it.
So I'm grateful.
I'm grateful for life. I have a catena of a shadow. Someone even live
it. I can't talk all, man.
Yes, look at the changes. Look at the things that happen. I got so much to thank Him for. So much to bless Him for. Yeah. Tonight, let's just lift our voice. Let's begin to thank the Lord tonight for growing up, for watching over us, for keeping us, for protecting us, for shielding us. They were a little bit hard growing up. Father, this evening we want to thank you in a special way. We just bless you for being here. We thank you for showing up on our behalf. We thank you for working in our lives. We thank you for manifesting your grace, your glory. We worship you from the depth of our hearts. We thank you, Spirit of God. Tonight we want to be grateful. We just want to be grateful. Our being in your presence tonight is to tell you thank you. Yes, Lord, we have not reached the climax, the zenith of our lives, but for where we find ourselves, we can look back and say, had it not been that you were faithful, you were so committed to our well-being, you were interested in changing the dynamics as it relates to our personal lives, we wouldn't be where we are. And this evening, we say thank you. Thank you so much for keeping us alive, for keeping us safe. It was by your grace, it was by your faithfulness, it was by your diligence, it was by your commitment to see the best come out of us when others did not see what you saw, oh God. You touch hearts, you move people. We thank you for those you use, men and women you use along the way to encourage us, Lord, to be there for us and make us listen. Counsel us, give us advices when we needed the advices, when we needed the insight, when we needed the correction, even when we were disciplined and we didn't understand everything about it. We thank you, Father, for being there. Father, we want to thank you for the things you brought us into, the opportunities you've given us, for the fulfillments you've established in our lives, for the different things you've accomplished in and through our lives. Tonight, we want to thank you. We want to bless your name. We want to say we give you praise, we give you glory. We bless your name. It was by your grace we are what we are. We can say like Paul, by your grace we are what we are. We bless you for being our King, for being our God, for being our hope, for being our joy, for being our life, for being everything to us. We bless your holy, wonderful, and glorious name. You are holy, you are worthy, you are mighty, you are awesome, you are exalted, you are lifted up. Thank you, Ancient of Days. Thank you, mighty God. Thank you, great I am. Thank you, the one who was, the one who is, the one who is to come. We appreciate you, Lord. We bless you, Lord. We honor you, Lord. Thank you for that. Thank you, Lord. Thank you for our glory, Lord. Thank you for providing, supplying, protecting, shielding, opening doors, opportunities. Thank you for the right network, right connections. Yes. Thank you, Lord. Lord, some of them come from the best backgrounds. Our parents didn't have everything. But you provided for them. You supplied them to give us the best, to bring us to where we are. Some of us didn't have to live with parents, live with guidance. You were able to supply these people and allow them to love us like your own, oh God, and bring us up, God. I want to thank you tonight. I want to bless you. I want to bless you also, Lord, for you enabling us to make quality and sound decisions that have yielded this far. And Father, we want to bless your name today. Father, we will pray for those who have challenges and have gone through different kind of errors. We pray that these days of your word will bring a transformation, bring a revolution. To know that, Lord, that you are able to do exceedingly abundantly. Oh God, you are able to do exceedingly abundantly above all we can ask, think, or even imagine. We bless you, Jesus. We give you praise. We give you glory. We give you worship. We give you adoration. Yeah. Thank you, Jesus.
Jesus found me just as I am.
Yeah.
And he heard my word. We're singing. We're singing forever.
Forever I praise my God
in the presence of your majesty. We're singing majesty.
We're singing about all tonight.
Your grace has found me just as I am. Empty-handed, but let me obey. We sing it.
Yeah, we're singing majesty, majesty. Your grace has formed me just as I am. Empty-handed, but alive in your hands. Forever I'm changed by your love. In the presence of your majesty, listen to me. No matter what's going wrong, no matter where you are, it takes its grace. Empty-handed, but alive in your hands. Forever changed by your love, oh God. We bless you.
Lift up a new song.
Yes, sir. Can someone leave hands and worship him tonight? What a time to be in his presence, to adore him. I am your grace, your grace. Mamma, come on, Marie, Lord, you're never seeing it. Mama Marema Kosiba Kata. Brenda Rabashikabara. Ayabakasi and Arababurama Kata. Morama Narema and Arabosa. Uba Mareba Kashikaba and Araba. Oh, Baba Kabare Nere Mashina Makata. Ayawa Siya Katalaba. Mama Rema Moshe Katola Bosi. Mama. Zibaraba Koshi Katalaba Raba. Somebody help me worship him. Worship him or worship him, Moga. Makabaraba Koshi Talaba. Baraba. Mama Kabaraba Katalaba Kiyanaba.
We sing it.
Oh, someone worship
him.
Give him praise. Bless his name. Reach out to him. Pour your spirit forever changed by your love in the presence of your majesty. We thank you. We thank you, oh God.
We sing it now.
Majesty, oh,
Majesty, you praise,
you praise us for me, just as I am, empty-handed but alive in your hands.
Empty-handed but alive in your hands.
Oh, Majesty, you praise. Mandoria Nerevasi and Anabaya. Forever I am changed. In the presence of your majesty.
For
yesterday. Majesty. Jesus, we give you praise and honor. Your grace has found me, just as I am. Empty-handed, Lord, empty, but alive in your head. We sing it, let you see. Oh, majesty, Lord, forever let him change us. Forever I am changed by you. In the presence
of your majesty, we praise you, O God. Lift up a new song. Oh, we praise you, Lord.
Yeah.
We bless your name.
Mama Maramana.
Mama Maramana.
Forever I'm changed by your love in the presence of your majesty. Your grace has formed me just as I am. Empty-handed, but alive in your hands. I thank you tonight for the opportunity. Bless you so much. I'm what I am because of your grace. Thank you for everyone, everywhere, following us, oh God. I pray that your grace will be applied, your presence will be made manifest. I thank you for this night of discovering encounter. I thank you for showing yourself mighty. We'll lift our burdens. We'll pour everything at your altar. We shall have your way. As we look to the power of your word tonight, we ask you, God, to teach us. We've come to learn of you that we'll have rest for our souls. You say your yoke is easy and your burden is light. Thank you tonight. Thank you, Lord. Thank you so much. We bless you, Jesus. Thank you, Spirit of Truth. Bless you, Jesus. Yes, we thank you. As you go into God's Word tonight, we bless you so much for granting us the opportunity. We thank God for all of you that continue to follow us over the past days. in our evening broadcast, the Bread of Life of the Sowing Evangelistic Ministries. And this comes to you on Swami TV only. Over the past days, we've been studying on the power and the benefit of great decisions. And we share that the height of your life, whatever you attain to, the legacy that you leave behind, the change you intend, you envisage, the dimension of ministry, personal life, career, family, whatever that you hope to achieve to the fullest, that will be meaningful and that will be a blessing and that will not be ignored in your generation, is not by coincidence. These great achievements, these great accomplishments are fulfilled on the platform of decisions. And the dimension of the decisions you make determine the output, the kind of decisions that come forth. And we, as we begin sharing with you, we took time to take you to the scriptures. One of the scriptures uses Joshua 24, 1 to 15. Also took time to look at Daniel 1, 1 to 9. We took time to look at 2 Kings chapter 7, also 1 to 9. And maybe other buttressing scriptures. We talk about the power. We talk about the benefit. We talk about the word great. We talk about the decisions. We took time to explain that. If you want to have dinner, you can just go back into our different videos, go to our YouTube, and just type in Simon Cully, and you see great decisions, the power of great decisions there. You can also go to our Facebook page, and our watch party goes through the day, you know, including the different videos that you can watch. So once you go to our watch party on our page, you will see those things happening through the day. Yeah. So we're taking the time to make you have this information, and they are there to help build your capacity to make sure that whatever you want to achieve and whatever you want to accomplish, you can have the requisite information to be able to do that. The Bible says faith comes by hearing and hearing the word of God. We also took time to lay out some platforms that will make us, you know, have a foundation for what we're discussing. Out of the scriptures read, there was some insight that came. One of them, like I shared in my mother, I said, great accomplishments, fulfillment of destiny, the leaving of legacy, doing well on the stage of life, winning the battles, true restoration. Because all of these, either some of us are going after, or some of us are going after some, and or some are going after, you know, few of it. True restoration, breaking beyond the limits. There are some people that are all they know is limitation around their life and family over the years and the generation. And in their mind, they want to break beyond those limitations, breaking beyond the limitation, becoming the envy of the earth. There are people all they know is being the pity of the earth. People feeling sorry for them. People, be, you know something. And they want to become now the envy of the earth instead of being the pity of the earth. Rising from the ashes. There are people who find themselves in ashes, etc. Will never be possible without a sincere and concrete decision made. That means all of these things I achieve on the platform of decisions. I will talk about it so you can go in our previous video. The product of your life is directly proportional to the quality of decisions, to the quality of decision one makes or might have made over a period of time. People, lives, families, and institutions become great and remain so because of the quality of decisions they make. All right? So you can't blame anyone and say, oh, the reason why so-and-so thing is like this because, you know, then you know. No. It's quality of decisions they make. The quality of decision you make would determine whether certain things will work or certain things will be possible. The quality of decisions that they make. All right. For many of us, the pattern of life we have engaged may not deliver to us our expectation. Are we prepared to make some major adjustments in different areas? I mean, many of us now who are alive right now, there are decisions we made. And based on the decision we made and what we want, they cannot come to pass. They cannot be fulfilled. Why? Because what you want and the kind of decisions you are making don't correlate. They don't fall in place. You know, there's no way. The Bible says, be not deceived. God is not mocked. Whatever a man soweth, that is what he's going to reap. So whatever you don't want to reap, don't sow it.
You know, and it comes to issue of decision. You cannot be making bad decisions and expect good results. You cannot be, you know, aligning yourself with the wrong people, wrong advisors, wrong counsel, wrong, just everything in it. And then you expect that and making headway all around the place. It just doesn't work. It doesn't work in a personal life. It doesn't work in a family life. It doesn't work in a community, in a nation life, in government, in private sector. What business? It just doesn't work there. You know? You want the right results? Surround yourself with the right people. Now, if we're not getting the desired results, are we prepared to make major adjustments in different areas of our lives in order to have maximum output from now on? And you know, in the previous night, we talked, I said, go and check it. We talked about the prodigal son. He left. He left the right company and went to the wrong company. Everything was squandered. Everything was destroyed. Everything went down the drain. His life was reduced and everything. He was subjected. But guess what? The Bible said he didn't remain there and die with it. He didn't say, but anyway, I already made a mistake, I already inside. No, he said the Bible said when he came to himself. He decided to make major adjustments, radical adjustments. Some of you, where you are right now, the state you find yourself in right now, you will need some radical adjustment. Radical, I mean radical. You're not going to take your time. You have to be radical in your adjustment. You have to be able to be forceful in your adjustment. You have to be able to make decisions that people think that you're crazy. Why? Because there has to be a turnaround. Certain turnarounds will require some radical decisions. So I make maximum adjustment in different areas of your life in order to have maximum output from. One of God's greatest gifts to a man, to a person, is his independent will. And that's what a lot of people misuse. And that's also, the devil also takes advantage of and allow a lot of people to finish themselves. Yes. One of God's greatest gifts to you is your independent will. Nobody can control your will. And a lot of people, you know, thrive on that and tend to destroy themselves because they don't destroy other people. That's something that they do affect other people, but they end up destroying themselves. You know, it's my life. Yes, it's your life. Nobody can control it. Nobody can influence it. But guess what? Your independent will goes with consequences. Decisions you make has result. Every decision you make, good or bad, has result. All right, Jesus said, no good tree brings bad fruit, and no bad tree brings good fruit. So he said, by the fruits you know them. So if you see bad fruit, you know the kind of decision that has been made, the kind of thing that has been put in. And so you have to make it. It's important. You must make it. And you have an independent will, but you must align it to God. You must align to prayer. His grace and power in your life will make a great impact based on decisions. God's grace is available. God's power is available. But God's grace and our power are useless if people don't make good decisions. If people make crazy decisions, listen to me, God's grace and God's power will be powerless to work in your life. So if you want to see God do awesome things in your life and change the course of events and make a difference in your life, listen to me, you must be able to make some good decisions. All right? The strength of God can be seen through the decisions you will network through. Yeah, the strength of God. That means God is all-powerful, God is all-knowing, God is mighty, God is great. But listen to me today. Listen to me today. If you, as a child of God, don't make the right decision and you begin to fail in everything, people cannot say God is a failure because you failed. No. God remains who he is in spite of your errors and your mistakes. You've chosen not to align. Listen, the Bible says with God all things are possible. With God all things are. Someone must partner with God. Someone must make up their mind. That's why in Proverbs 16:9 it says, a man will plan his ways. God will order his steps. A man will plan his ways. God will order his steps. You must sit down. You must plan. You must put a structure together. You must put something together. And then God will order you. God will guide you. God will tell you, okay, don't do this now. Don't attempt this now. Put this aside for a while. Okay, go after this. And God, commit your ways to him and trust him, and he will bring it to pass. Listen to me. It's important. Now, how do I make quality decisions? How do I make good decisions? How? How do I make good decisions? One, I make good decisions based on the quality and quantity of information available to me. A person will make quality and good decisions based on the quality and quantity of information available to them. All right? Let's look at some scripture. Matthew chapter 11, 28 to 30. What does the word of God say? Matthew chapter 11, 28 to 30. What does it say? Matthew chapter 11:28-30. Matthew 11:28-30. What does it say? If you got a scripture, we'll read something like this. Do I'm trying to get it, Papa? It says, "Come unto me, all of you that have labor and heavy laden, and I will give you a rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn of me. For I am gentle in spirit, and in me you will find rest." Yeah. "Come unto me, all of you who are labor and are heavy laden and overburdened, and I will cause you to rest. I will ease and relieve and refresh," well, I like my your soul. "Take my yoke upon you and learn of me, for I am gentle, meek, and humble, lowly in your heart, and you will find rest, relief, and rest, and ease, and refreshment, and recreation, and be quiet for with your soul. For my yoke is wholesome, useful, good, not harsh, hard, sharp, oppressive, but comfortable, gracious, and pleasant. And my burden is light and easy to be borne." This is Jesus speaking to his disciple. He said, "Come to me, all of you, and I will give you rest." That means I will give you rest. Then he said, "How is your rest going to take place?" He said, "Take my yoke upon you and learn of me." That means information, quality information, quantity information, both quality and quantity. The quality of information and the quantity, both of them are together. The quantity you have should be quality. You should not have quantity by quantity. Quantity of useless information. You need quantity of quality information. I mean, the level of information you have determines how the level of decision you make. The quality of the decision can never be above the level of information that you have. Your information will determine the quality of decision that you have, you make. And that's why today I want some people hear people doing things and they do it for formality. So now I hear people say, "I got an advisor. I got this," and you wonder whether they really have advisors. Because their action tells you that indeed they don't have advisors. Board of advisors, board of this, you know, special advisor on this, special advisor on that. People put institutions together in the community. Something. And guess what? They have all the positions and they don't consult any people. They don't even talk to them. They don't discuss with them. They don't discuss anything. You know? So that they give people position for formality. The person you are asking to be an advisor, do you respect them to take advice from them? Or you just want to fill the position because people are telling you to fill position? No, you don't do that. Listen, you are not forced. You are not forced to have anyone advising you. Said you know everything in life and you can achieve everything by yourself. You're not forced to have people advising you. You're not forced. Nobody should put you on a duty and compare you to get advisors in your life. Once you think it's not necessary, don't kill yourself with it. Why? Because if you even put them in, you're not going to listen and you don't respect them. You don't look up to them. You don't believe that they can offer you anything. And guess what? I usually tell people, if you in life don't have access to certain dimensional information, anything, and you make us, you live in the illusion, like you know, you are a disaster waiting to happen. It's just a matter of time. You are a disaster waiting to happen. Why? Because everyone that will succeed, achieve, make impact, change the course of life, needs counsel. If I was in a modern day of counselors, they accept it. In a modern day of counselors, they accept it. Counselor is not because you don't know. Counselor is to open your mind, to see life from a different perspective, to see life from another dimension, you know? And that's why it's good to have the right kind of company around you. The right kind, because you may be seeing things in the perspective and believe that it's the best until someone with deeper wisdom and deeper insight comes up with you and shows you from another angle. And by the time you add your angle to their angle and add it to the third or fourth angle, you got a complete information. Probably your information was good, but it was half information. So by the time somebody else network with you and bring another information, and somebody brings another one, and somebody brings another one, it doesn't mean you don't know. It simply means you may know something, but you don't know everything. And somebody else has another part of the pie, another part of the puzzle, and if you can put the entire puzzle together, you can have a complete being or the complete things you are looking for. Because what you may be looking for may be with somebody else. And that's why advisors are needed. That's why counselors, and that's why network is needed. That's why relationships are built. That's why people get connected to other people for the purpose of building their information capacity, for expanding whether you call it consultancy, whether you call it expert advice, whether you call it spiritual advice, or what kind of counsel you're talking about, listen to me. The reason why is the quality and quantity of information. Jesus speaking to his disciples, he said, come. He said, come and learn of me. But he said, I know some of you come to the ministry, you hear about the things of God, you think it's a difficult thing. He said, when you sit down with me and I teach you ministry and I give you the understanding, you know, in Matthew 16, he said, thou Peter, and upon this rock I will build my church, and the gates of hell will not prevail. And I will give you the keys of the kingdom, that whatever you bind on earth will be bound in heaven, whatever you lose on earth will be loose in heaven. Jesus was talking about this. Listen, the kingdom has insight, it has information, it has, there's a dimension of information that you dive into God's truth and God's word, that it opens your understanding. Paul speaking to Timothy in the book of Timothy, I think it's First or Second Timothy, chapter 3. He said, of a child, you have known the Holy Scriptures, which is able to make you wise unto salvation. He said, for it, as from a child, from the time you grow up as a baby, the word that your he said, the faith that is in you started in your grandmother, then it was passed to your mother. So Timothy, you are a third generational Christian. The information, that your dimension of information is so high because your grandmother was loaded. She was able to empower your mother. Now your mother have transitioned into you. So Timothy, you are three generations. You are the third generation of three generations of the Christian faith moving in your family. And moreover, from the time you were a baby, you were taught in the world. You were taught the different principles. You were taught the different guidance of God. You were taught the things that have the ability to build people up and make them make impact and be a light and a spectacle to their generation. And Paul, Timothy, you can know this, which is able to make you wise unto salvation. Then he says that, and all scripture is God's breath. He said, and is profitable one for reproof, for correction, and for training one in righteousness, so that the man of God may be thoroughly equipped for every good work. That means to make good decisions, to make quality decisions, so at the end of the day, he will yield mighty results. All right? So Paul was sharing with Timothy and giving an insight. He said, Timothy, the information dimension in you is so high. He said, in chapter 4, he tells, he said, no, don't let anybody despise you because you are young. He said, he said, don't let anybody despise you because you are young. He said, all you need to do is be an example in words. He said, be an example in words. He said, be an example in your words, be an example in the things of it. He said, everything you have been taught, everything, every information that has been made available to you. He said, listen to me. He said, practice it. He said, if you walk by it, you can rest assured that you're not going to make any error. So listen, you cannot make quality decisions outside quality information and the quality and quantity information. So that you have quality information, but if it's small, you can make much impact. So every day of your life, just because you got some level of insight and truth, let somebody go to school and learn this thing today. I remember many years ago when I worked in the computer field, what the dimension of computer science we learned was, it was helping the world at that time. But over the years, when I left pretty close about that, something like 1995, I resigned from came to full time ministry in 1995. All right. So you're talking about pretty close to about 25 years ago. All right. 25 years ago when I left. Now, in 25 years, the computer industry have advanced. A lot of things have come up. Yes, I may have had knowledge then, but if I'm going to be relevant in that environment, I have to upgrade. I have to network with a lot of people, get a lot of information, build my insight, and be able to update myself to present day realities. Because the information I had, yes, was good, but there are so much information that have come over the past 25 years that eventually I will need. And that's what I'm trying to do over the years, to update myself from time to time, not giving too much of time, but at least keep it open with certain issues that if it came up, I'll be able to address one or two things and I'm able to give some level of contribution. But listen to me. The quality of information is important. Also, the quantity of information is important. But the quality and quantity has to work together. Show me somebody who has enough of good information. I will show you somebody who has the capacity of producing good results. And so, if you will do it, it's important. So, I just quote a 2 Timothy 2:15. In 2 Timothy 2:15, it says, study to show yourself approved. Study to show yourself approved unto God. A workman that need not be ashamed, but rightly dividing the word of truth. That means If you, listen, if you are in ministry and you are a servant of God, and you will be properly able to divide God's word, that when you speak God's word, you will not be saying something crazy and be talking out of the box. You must be a student of the word. Your dimension of information, your dimension of build-up from God's word has to be deep. It has to be strong. You have to give enough time to the Bible, to Bible literatures, to things that center around it. Whatever field that you find yourself, if you're going to offer quality, if you're going to give good output, if you're going to be one of those that will be respected and singled out in that particular career, then your level of insight, your in-depth knowledge concerning whatever you are a part of is very, very much important. The quality and the quantity is important. And so today, I encourage you to go for quality information and to go for quantity information. Not just few quality, but make sure you go, if you have quality, go for as much of the quality as you have, as you can go for. Right now, it may be available to you. It is in people, relationship, people you are connected to, network with them, build relationship, learn from them the things you need to learn from them. Because you never know that those people will never be with you forever. Because sometimes God brings people into your life for a certain season to learn certain things, to know certain things, to develop yourself in certain things. Like right now, a lot of you are following us on our on Facebook Live, and you are getting all this different information. And why is God making this available to you? You never know. It's you in a lockdown and you're getting all this information, but you never know what God is setting you up for. There will be something great ahead of you. There will be something mighty ahead of you that God wants to do with you. And God is using this period to feed you with information, to develop you, to let you understand that what you have is not enough. You need more than what you have. You need more than what you have. You need to change your emphasis. You need to refocus. You need to redirect yourself. So at the end of the day, the level output you will get will be great and will cause people to wonder. Oh yes, it will cause people to wonder. They'll be wondering, how did he arrive at this place? How did he achieve this? How did he accomplish this? How did this work? And you will become a surprise and an amazement to your generation. Oh yeah, I see you being there. Tonight, I see you increasing in quality information. I see you increasing quality information. I see a hunger for God, a hunger for his word, a hunger for information, a hunger for every level of truth in life, not just Bible truth, but every level of truth in life. Whatever field you find yourself in, the truth that is attached to that field, that is identified with that field, that delivers the actual result, may you be exposed to it. And as you are exposed to it, may the Lord cause you to have enough of it, and may there be a hunger consistent to dive deeper and deeper into that truth, so that you stand out as first among equals. You know, first among what? Equals. Primus inter pares. You know, that's the Latin word. First among equals. So you stand out. God wants you standing out. You know, standing out. I'm on my way to computer school day. The school I graduated from, our class, our motto was primus inter pares. That means among equals, wanted to be first. So we were always, I like my CEO then, he was always going for new information, new softwares, dive into new things. And so every time you got around him, you learn something new. You will spend hours and days. Because I got addicted, you know, I started following him. I got addicted to the computer. I was constantly, I got to a point I would sit and teach classes without even looking in the computer, looking in the book. Why? Because there was this passion, there was this hunger, there was a desire. Then when I came to the ministry, my passion for kingdom truth became deeper, and I began going after and diving after. And you go to look at my library, books, tapes, different leaders, those who are making headways, you know, those who are ahead of us, those who we see as our touch bearers. Listen, where others are today, you can get there if you are not there, based on how well you prepare yourself. It's not by coincidence. Everything in life, every level of success and achievement in life is consciously worked out. It's not by incident. It's not by accident. And so we need to stop living this wishful kind of thinking and begin to prepare ourselves and develop ourselves and make sure that we take the next set of decisions that will place us at a certain place in life. And I see that happening in your life, especially in this particular season. I see God giving you the passion to do things you never did before, to have a hunger like never before, to have a desire like never before, to have a deep emphasis in direction you never took serious before. Why? Because it is a new day, it is a new season, and you're about to bring about a mighty change. I wish I can get an amen for you there. I said, I wish I can get an amen. I wish you could say amen, and I want to see it ringing on my picture. I want you to say amen. That means you agree with me, that you want to see that God is going to do that thing. God is going to bring that change. God is going to restore you. God is going to help you. Even if you made mistakes in your life that are yielding bad results today, I still believe the Lord will and can restore you, and he's going to do it to his glory and honor. And no devil can stop you. Your destiny will be fulfilled. The things you were called to do, you will accomplish it. Before you leave this earth, you will shake this generation. Your name will be a weight in the earth. In the name of Jesus Christ, you are going to be an answer provider. You ought to be a solution provider. You will not be a question. You will not be a problem. I decree that over your life in the name of Jesus, that God will use you as his mighty battle axe and as his weapons of war and as an instrument of light, of hope, and a beacon of hope to this generation. I see that happening with you. Oh, I'm too convinced. The second thing we need to talk about tonight, as we are closing. The second thing we need to talk about. Oh yeah. What a great way to flow in whatever the Lord is doing. Yeah. Listen to me. The quality of information will determine the results you get. It will determine it. If you don't have the quality information, you're not going to get the kind of results. Yeah. So if you make good decisions, you can rest assured that your future will produce something great. It's not just empty prophecy. Yeah. My tomorrow will be greater than today. Yeah. It will be greater than today. Yeah. Yeah. My tomorrow will be greater than today. Daddy cannot reach to you.
His eyes
in the blind. Daddy cannot see your tears. His ears are not deaf, that he cannot hear you cry. Your tomorrow with me must be greater than today. And that's what we declare over you tonight. No matter what I see, no matter what I see, no matter what comes my way, no matter how I cry, one thing I know, that is definite in my heart. My tomorrow must be greater than today. Someone help me prophesy what your own life is tonight. No matter what comes my way, no matter how I cry, one thing I know, I said, that is definite. Yes, help me tonight. I'm going to sing it by tomorrow. Join me and sing. I'm going to testify in my tomorrow. One thing I know that is definite in my heart. My tomorrow will be greater than today. Yeah. Tomorrow we're going to continue talking about the quality of people. We got to be able to know the quality of people. When you get quantity of information, you talk about the quality of people. I'm going to dive into that. And we're going to start from the quality of information and still move up. There are still some stuff we need to touch in the area of the quality of information. We're going to give you some examples of people who did a lot, you know, in building their information capacity. They did not only build their information capacity, they build their human resource capacity. And today you can see them as giants and icons of great success. Not because only they are smart, but they were able to create a team that they network with over the period and are producing a particular result. Listen to me. Your strength in life is not based just only on what you know or what you have. It's also based on those around you, because you can draw on the strength of those around you. I just tell people, I don't just want to be a leader, I want to be a great leader. And a great leader is surrounded by other leaders. A great leader does not surround himself with followers. You surround yourself with other leaders. Though they may follow you, but they are leaders. You take counsel from them. You take advice from them. You listen to what they say. You may have one part of the pie. They have another part of the pie. You have one part of the puzzle. They have another part of the puzzle. And with this kind of combination and collective effort, a lot of things can be achieved. Today we have a lot of problems with people succeeding because they are intimidated by people who know. They all want to keep themselves around people who are ignorant and think that that's the best place to be safe. Brother, that's the most insecure environment. To have people around you who don't know what you're talking, who don't understand the dynamics of issues, who are ignorant. A lot of you feel comfortable there, but that's what we're not doing very well. You need people around you who knows what to do, who know exactly what to do, who are resourceful, who can give you what you need at the particular time you need it and bring a change to your life. Yeah, that is definitely in my heart. My tomorrow. So many people have to change your friends. You have to make some adjustment in your friendship. There are some people that have to be demoted just to regular friendship. Some of them have to be demoted from the place of advisors and counselors. They have to be demoted to just regular friends that you say hello, hello to every day. They can't be the one you are sharing certain information with. People have to be gotten out of your sight. But there are people you need to disconnect from. Most of the bad results you are getting is based on the kind of attachment that you have. And you have to make that decision. It's been difficult for you to make that decision. But today I join heaven and I network with you today that those relationships will be disconnected for you to make progress. There are people who are needed out of your life right now for you to get to where God wants you to get to. And it's going to happen. I believe God by the anointing. Yes, prophesy my tomorrow. My tomorrow must be greater. Far greater. I can see it up in heaven, pouring down blessings. That's it. In my life. Heaven is pouring down blessings in my life. Pouring down blessings in your life. Tomorrow. A better tomorrow. Can someone lift your voice and join me to prophesy that?
I can see.
That's it.
Check me up tomorrow.
There's gonna be a great difference. There's gonna be a great difference. When you check me up tomorrow, you're gonna see a lot of difference. Tomorrow. Things will not be the same. God is setting you up for a bomb, for a blast, and for a positive change. Because you are making great decisions. We bless God. We give him praise. What a way to end that session tonight. It's been great being with you. I thank God for you being there. And I thank God for God using you as a blessing. And we thank God that we can always work together as a team. Until we meet again tomorrow evening on another broadcast of The Bread of Life. Handling the topic, the power and the benefit of great decisions. I'm Apostle Sammy, I'm calling you, and I hope you've been blessed. Like I can say, we need your feedback. Yes, I mean. And we share this video, encourage as many persons to come on and learn these lessons so that we can have a better family, better individuals, better communities, better society, and change our world in a positive way. I pray that indeed God bless you in a mighty way until we meet again. The friend said, dear business. God bless you in a special way. I also want to give you the opportunity, if you've been listening to us and you have not given your life to Christ, we want to give you that opportunity so that after hearing all this wonderful teaching that you have the empowerment to achieve it. And if you're that person, I'd like you to lift your hands and say, Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, I thank you today. I realized from the word I've heard tonight that I need to be with you. But I also know I'm a sinner and I need your salvation. I thank you for sending Jesus to die for me because I believe that he died on Calvary for my sins. Today I accept you into my heart. Thank you, Jesus, for forgiving me and being my Lord and Savior. Come into my heart. Be my Lord. Be my Savior. I accept your sacrifice in Jesus' name. Amen. I want you to know that that decision you made is a great decision and it's a turning point in your life. And all you need to do is to stay committed to God to that decision. Build a prayer life. Study God's word. Find mentorship. Find a church to grow up in. So for now, we are not going to regular service, but you can stay attached to this platform.
and keep building yourself, because we have three in life: the morning section, the 30 a.m. to 7:30. We have the 10 to 11, and we have the 8 to 9 everyday broadcasting. Apart from that, on our watch party throughout the day, there are different messages playing. So if you go there, you'll see series of messages playing through the day, you know, and you can go and build your capacity and strengthen yourself. It's good having you, and we pray that you have a great night. We just like to pray with you before we close tonight. Father, I thank you. I want to bless you in a special way. I thank you for that brother. I thank you for that sister. I pray, oh God, that you show yourself strong on your behalf. I thank you, Lord, for manifesting your grace and glory. I cover them in the blood, and I cover them in your protection. Thank you, Lord. Take all the praise today. Let your name be praised. Let your name be exalted. We pray for healing. We pray for deliverance. We pray for restoration. We pray for sound decision that will lead to great results. Take all the glory and be magnified in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Amen.
My tomorrow must be greater than today.
His hands are not sure that it cannot reach to you. His eyes are never blind. Cannot hear you cry. Your tomorrow must be greater than today. Your tomorrow must be greater than today.
No matter what I face,
no matter,
no matter what I see,
no matter what comes,
no matter
my way,
what comes my way, hey, no matter how I cry,
one thing I know,
one thing I know,
my tomorrow.
Tomorrow, greater. Oh, my, 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 my.